Hi everyone, I am so excited to share today's dish with you. It is a Bengali delicacy called prawn malai curry, or in Bengali it's called chingri macher malai curry. It is a delicious dish and it's totally nostalgic for me. The speciality of this preparation is that it's made with just a handful of ingredients, but it tastes rich and so flavorful. I hope you guys like it. Let's get started.
This is 500 grams of prawns that has been nicely cleaned and deveined. To this, add some salt and some turmeric powder. Coat the prawns well and set them aside. To a grinder jar, add 3 to 4 gigantic garlic cloves like these, or 5 to 6 small ones, 1 inch piece of ginger and 2 green chilies. Grind them into a paste like that. Also make a paste of 1 small onion and set that aside as well. So our prep work is done. Now let us set a pot on medium heat and add 3 tablespoons of oil and 1 tablespoon of ghee. Once the ghee melts, we will add 2 1-inch pieces of cinnamon sticks, 1 large bay leaf.
So we're adding whole garam masalas, right? So at this point, you can go ahead and add 3 whole green cardamoms and about 4 to 5 cloves. But I don't really like to do that because when I'm eating a curry, those are so tiny that one of them falls in my mouth and I feel like, no. So I like to powder seeds from 3 green cardamoms and 4 cloves instead and add that powder along with the bigger whole spices like cinnamon and bay leaves that I can easily remove while I'm eating.
So I quickly powdered seeds from 3 green cardamoms and 4 to 5 cloves and I'm adding that in. You can add whole spices if you like. We will stir fry these spices till it turns aromatic. It should take approximately 15 seconds, not more. Next, we are going to add in the onion paste. We will stir fry the onion paste for approximately 5 minutes or till it turns golden brown in color. It's very important to get rid of the raw smell of onion. That looks golden brown, so at this point we are going to add in the ginger, garlic and green chili paste that we had made, and we are going to mix them up together and stir fry for approximately a minute. Now we are going to turn down the heat and add a quarter teaspoon of sugar. We want the sugar and the onions to caramelize together and form this deep brown color, like that. Make sure not to burn it though. Okay, we are not done yet. We are going to add 2 tablespoons of coconut milk and give that a quick stir. We are going to repeat that another time. What this does is that it makes the base of the gravy nice and velvety and smooth. You can see that there is oil oozing out and the base looks perfectly done. Now we are going to add in the marinated prawns in.
The prawns I used here are of medium sized and I bought it with the shells removed as well as it was deveined, which is great. But if I had a choice and I got like bigger sized prawns, I would probably leave the tail intact because that way when you fry it, it doesn't coil up and get little. It stays big and looks better. Also, the shell imparts flavor, so a lot of people don't remove the shells at all. You just devein it but leave the head and the tail intact. So it's up to you what you like to do.
And we are going to stir fry the prawns for approximately 2 minutes or so. Prawns cook really, really quick. We don't want to cook it really long because it turns hard and rubbery. So as soon as you see that they are starting to curl up a little and form opaque kind of orangish color like that, you know that it's done. At this point, we are going to add in 1 can or 400 ml of coconut milk. I'm going to rinse out the can a little bit and next add a pinch of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder and 1.5 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder for a nice color. Add salt to taste and mix well. Next we'll add 3 green chilies. Don't worry, all the chilies are going to be masked by the coconut milk and this curry is not going to be too hot. Place the lid on and let the gravy simmer for approximately 5 minutes. Next, we are going to add 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder, and that's it. Mix well and let the gravy reduce till it becomes slightly thick and oily, like a nice and rich consistency. You'll see what I mean. It's been like 5 minutes of simmering, and now let's see how the gravy looks. See, can you feel that it forms a nice viscous kind of consistency? That's perfect. Let's check for salt. Add more salt if needed, and we are almost done. The last thing we want to do is add 1/2 tablespoon of ghee, and your prawn malai curry is ready. That's it. Isn't that an easy preparation?
I told myself I'm going to post this curry if and only if it tastes just like my parents made it, and it does. It does. It is so good. The gravy of this curry has a rich feel to it. You don't need any nut paste, any heavy cream, nothing is required. Another thing you can do is add some yogurt. A lot of people do that to make the base of the curry a little thick, but my parents never did, and honestly, you don't need it. Just follow how I'm asking you to make it and you will love it. I hope you guys enjoyed the recipe. You're probably thinking, no cumin powder, no coriander powder, no coriander leaves. This is such a simple preparation, but if you cook it the way I showed it, it's going to turn out to be a very soothing tasting and very rich tasting curry. It has a slight sweetness coming from the coconut milk and the caramelized onions, and it also has slight notes of garam masala, and that's all that's needed. It's beautiful. Just try it. So that's all for today, my friends. If you haven't subscribed to my channel as yet, you see what you're missing out? So make sure to press that subscribe button and also press the bell notification so the next recipe comes straight to you. If you're on any of these different social media sites, I'm going to be waiting to say hello. And if you prefer written recipes rather than these videos, you can always visit my blog. All the links are in the description. So, see you next week. Bye-bye.